Happy Friday, third graders. We made it through another week. You guys are doing a great job. We are going to start our day with recording our daily Flipgrid. So you'll go ahead, click on the link. I'm having you guys create story problems today. So please go back sometime today after you're done recording yours and answer some of your classmates' questions, okay? Then we are going to read chapter 8 of Tales of a Fourth Grade Nothing. Fill in the form when you are done. And our independent reading for today. You just need to do 15 minutes since we're also reading our novel. So 15 minutes, make sure you fill in the reading log. And if you want, you can check out the reading room and read some of those chapter books that are in there. After that, we're gonna go ahead and do Imagine Learning for about 20 minutes. And then today for writing, this is the last day for writing. So today is day 10. We're publishing. For most of us, you probably don't have much to do here because we've already written them out. You've been revising them as we go and editing. So really today is just your final day to kind of read through them and then submit it. And I will grade it this weekend. I did right here put down a third grade writing rubric. So if you open this up, this is how I'm going to basically grade your writing here. So I'm going to look at the introduction. So a basic would be no introduction to the topic is provided, but subject can be inferred. That would be a basic. You want to get kind of in this column right here. You want it to be proficient. So you want to see, you want to have that your topic is introduced, related information is grouped together, and when appropriate, illustrations are included to aid comprehension. You guys aren't going to have illustrations. So I'm just going to take that out right now. So don't even worry about that. Okay. Your details, those would be your subtopics. Linking words would be our transitions and your conclusion. Okay, so go ahead. You can take a look at this. This is how I'm going to go ahead and look at it when I'm looking at it this weekend. Okay, and then go to day 4. That's where your report is. Some of you are doing a great job with this and you're having no problems opening it. Some of you are having a hard time opening it. If that's the case, what you can do is you can go up here to the waffle, click on it, click on a Google Doc. It will open up a brand new document for you. And just click on this blank one right here, click on it, and write your animal report here. And then you can share it with myself. So you have to name it first, but you would share it with, and you would just type in my name, Callie Childress, and it should pop up. Okay. Hopefully though, I mean, most of you seem to be doing fine with getting your animal, opening it up. So if hopefully you don't need to do that. For math today, you're just going to go to Dreambox, set your timer for 35 minutes. See if you can get 5 lessons done. We're finishing up reading maps today, so get those slides turned in. It looks like 9 of you have already done that, so that's awesome. Today for Mrs. Schrode, make sure that you guys are going to her PE classroom, and since it is Friday, make sure that you're filling in that form for her, because she needs that for your PE grades and PE credit. And then for our optional activity for today, we have literature and our art project, so I'm just going to open this up real quick to show you. Today we are going to be studying shapes and optical illusions. So here I have a little picture of shapes, and then here are what I mean by optical illusions here. So for our books here, we have 3 books to read, The Greedy Triangle, If You Were a Quadrilateral, and Windows, Rings, and Grapes. They are all about shapes. If you click on the book, it'll take you to the YouTube video where it reads it to you. If you click on the level, it'll take you to the little title down here, it's a little label. It'll take you to Accelerated Reader, and you can take a quiz on it, and the quiz numbers are underneath the books. For the art project, what's cool about this art project, I know this one has color, but really all you need is a pencil and a piece of white paper. You can even use the back of a piece of scrap paper. If you have a Sharpie might be really cool to use with this. So here are a couple examples of some optical illusions. You would just click on the picture and it'll take you to the YouTube tutorial on how to do it. It's actually not as hard as you think it is. What's great about the videos, you guys, is you can pause them at any time or watch the whole video and then go back, watch it again and pause it, draw what you need to, and then unpause it, watch the next, 10 or 15 seconds, pause it again, draw it on your paper, and then kind of just keep doing that until you are finished. Okay, so that's what I have for you guys today. We made it through another week. You guys are doing great. Thank you for all of your hard work. If you have any questions, let me know. and I will talk to you on Monday. Have a great weekend, you guys.